Okay, let's switch gears now to, let's talk friendship. And let's talk about Alex Ekubo, who is your best friend. And we grew in the last year or two, or three actually, you know, to see you guys on red carpets, at events together. And in the last couple of months, things have been different. What happened with the friendship?
Oh, the friendship is still there. It's a bit amazing how people are paying so much attention to the friendship. I think we're coming from a country whereby people, you can't please Nigerians. You know, I remember one of my spiritual responsibilities is to serve and to help people. So that is that was what I saw when I met my friend, when I met Alex. I was like, oh, okay, you have a lot of talent. You're very talented. Okay, what happens? Okay, you've not been on BBA, but I have been. I have a platform. You know what? Share my platform. Networking and everything. I'm going to do my best to introduce you to people, blah, 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 blah. And look at him today. He's a man. He has his own thing. He doesn't need me to do all these things. Now, these are the same Nigerians that will say on Facebook and Twitter, what have you done? How have you given back? Have you helped anybody? You're so self-centered. I'm like, I'm self-centered, but I'm helping. Then you start to help and drag your friends along. Everyone that knows me that if I have a friend, there's no how my friend will not grow. I'm passionate about growth. So, when we started going around, the only reason why we're going everywhere together was so that he could meet these people, because he had talent. He wasn't a talentless young man that was just moving around and saying, oh, look at me, I'm a fine boy. You understand? Fine, his platform was Mr. Nigeria, but he needed to be seen and heard. So that's why I was saying, guy, let's go. And I let him know that, look, these Nigerians, they're very hopeless people. Some of them, some of these Nigerians are very hopeless. So don't listen to the junk. The serious-minded people will know what is happening, but don't listen to the junk. He said, he doesn't care, which was good. He had a strong mind. And so he met people. He met producers, directors, actors. And of course, there's some of them you had to go an extra link to say, no, give him a shot, give him a try. And these same people, that's why I say, oh, there must be something between two of you. That's why two of you are going in there. What kind of friend? Don't worry, friend. I'm like, yo, I'm a decent guy. I'm not going to be one of those entertainers that will sleep with 50 women to prove that they are guy men. I'm not even going to advertise my relationship in public. You understand what I'm saying? So I'm like, whatever you guys want to say, say it. But we know what we're doing and everything is all good. So, you know, these are the same people that say, you have not helped anybody, you have you helped. You start helping someone, they say, oh, you're sleeping with them. Probably because that is what they do. You know, in Nigeria, a lot of people feel that you cannot give someone so much without getting something back in return, which is most likely sex. And most people feel that that is what they do. So, of course, they were going to assume that. And it was very ridiculous. And of course, it didn't affect the friendship because we would laugh. We'll sit back and laugh to see all these people. Because me, I know my friend. I know say he like woman well. And he knows me. He knows I'm a very disciplined man, but he knows that I like. And in fact, even my high school friends will be like, guy, now you they talk of like this. So they don't know what TV they call you for secondary school. I'm like, shh, I beg, not out me. You know. He said, you don't know them, man. Or Bimo could bring out all those your women. I say, no need. Leave them. I tell people, some people say, I defended you. I say, don't defend me. You'll be God. I'm like, leave them. Let them talk. So right now, he's at that point where I don't need to take him everywhere because he has made those connections, made those he's networked, and he's working. So when he's working, I'm also working. I mean, we're still friends till tomorrow.
So the friendship is still intact.
Of course, the friendship.
What we are thinking that it was a friendship.
Nigerians are okay now that we're not going everywhere together. Oh, they have fought. Oh, that I'm like, what do you people want? We're everywhere together. How can you people call me and say, Uti, I don't think it's wise. People are talking, and the same people are calling me that you should not allow what people say get to you. I'm like, what do you want? And you'll be like, you can pull your locks out. But it's fine. It's fine. Well, we're still cool.
Okay. Mm. Are you in a relationship?
That I'm not going to answer because I've answered that question one too many times and I've been misquoted and it has put a lot of pressure because there was once I was in a relationship.
You say yes or no question.
No. I need to tell because there might be somebody watching that might not be happy. There might be somebody that might not be happy.
So there's somebody.
There's somebody. But we've not given it a name.
Okay.
But there's someone.
There's something going on.
And the last time this happened, someone got very angry. Said, oh, you know how they can be. So, you mean, you know, and this is...
So basically, and this
is no, I'm not in a relationship. There's somebody. We've not given it a name. Because this is the same person that was like, oh, I don't want to be one of those trophy babes. I don't want to be one of those ones that, you know... I'm like, I didn't want people to know that we're having. I was like, oh, thank God, this is who I'm looking for. And then 2 months down the lane, on your Instagram, there was a photo of you and some girls on the table. So I'm not good enough. I'm like, but you're the same person. That's it. So I'm not going to, like I told, I always tell any girl I'm talking to, I'm not going to. The public has no business over my personal life. I'm going to keep it that way, and I want people to keep assuming so that my market will keep selling. So, yeah.
2014. What are your major plans?
I don't reveal my plans. I'm not going to reveal any plans.
Still gonna be doing movies, music, everything.
Of course, like no, normal now. I mean, there are a lot of surprises in the can. We're about to open up the can, and I'm a very spiritual person, so I've planned, I've given it to God. You know, the days where I would tell everybody, oh, this is what is going to happen, this is what I'm going to do, and it will just blow up in my face.
But definitely, so big things coming.
By God's grace, you know, we are praying and we are hopeful, and more of all I've been doing, and just in a bigger, better way. And yeah,
thank you very much. Events. You are definitely doing very well for yourself, and I'm sure that 2014 would not be any different. So. Well done. Thank you very much for being on the show. And yeah, we know you have a girlfriend now or whatever.
I did not say I have. Don't put me on the spot.
Thank you very much for joining us.
No pun intended.
Like I always say, you can join the conversation on Twitter at WhyNaija.tv is the handle, and the hashtag is Robbing Minds. Also the website WhyNaija.com/TV. Remember, you've never seen young people talk like this before. I'll see you next time. We represent What else? Come on.